if we are good in these formulas, we can work on any software, even if it is SAP or if it is a another technology can. But we should know how to use the tool. I hope everybody is working on your systems, means the IDS system which was provided by us. If not, really it is a you know, difficult part
you did
to you know continue. Please go to the IDS server, whatever we have you know working, and work more on the server, whatever you require. If you put your hands, definitely you will understand what I am going to explain and what I am explaining actually. Don't think after the completion of complete course I will start working. It won't really work. We have to wait for one more day still. Okay, we will continue. So our this is our schema, right? Which we are working on. We are running first. So what we are doing is we are generating the quota at the end of the month, which is you know end date. So 40 anyhow whenever you know that is the compensatory of if employee worked on any holiday, it is generating on the particular day. If you remember, 19th we have maintained the attendance. So if it is holiday, it is generating the compensatory of that. Apart from this, let us say we are generating the leave quota policy for end leave. Leave like every month end, it should create, you know, how much we are creating 2K. So here we are creating 2 for every month. So these are the time types we have. Sorry, these are the PCRs we have created. This PCR is calculating the present days. So after checking the probationary date, we are going to generate. We have built a you know big logic over here. If you remember the previous classes, so finally we are generating a you know. Okay, time type called Z901. We have a change in his what you say employee group. So basing on that, we have you know put some logics. Yep.
I just want to ask you one thing here. Even in my system, I was getting this. What is this NEXTRA, NEXTRB, NEXTRC? Next row, next row, next row.
See, when you are going to a PCR, this is the PCR
okay.
where you are getting, right? There are two
yes.
views. There are two views. Right, this is the PCR.
Z910.
If you see here, you can't see any next and all this stuff. When you go to table view.
Okay. I got it.
So there is a limitation over here, so it will show
okay.
all this stuff. Okay, because it's a table view, right? So it will show because it will go to the next slide.
Okay, I understood, Krishna. Please.
It's not a big thing. Actually, I don't think how remaining people work, but I will work on treating. Right? Whatever I am telling you based on the preview itself. Okay. Once you have written the things on review, you can check in the table view. So what this rule is doing is it is generating the rule. The time tap has two because there is a change in his employees, group, employee group. So there is a difference in the quota. So he is getting the number two. The quota number has two. So let us say if he terminated in between the month. Let us say for the fair case, what we'll do is. We will delete the action which we have taken for the employee. Right? If you have, again a mathematical confusion here, you will be a bit confused. Actually, he should be eligible for 2.5. Right? Because there is a we have it so one end from we will delete these two records. The organization will change. So from non-management, what we have taken an action. Yes, sir, the 2.5 action. So it should generate. So 2.5 we should get. Let us say we'll take a separation action exactly on 16th, whatever the record is there here. So what he should be eligible for 1.5 at the time of his separation. So now the employee belongs from 1st of April to 31999. To management group, and same with these things also, the actions what we have taken. I am just resetting the things. I think Rakesh, you arrived just now. Still we didn't started anything, right? So now we'll so this is the first case which we are generating the time quota with 2.5 because he is eligible for 30 leaves as per our policy. So he is getting 2.5 for the month of April. Let us say in the month of April itself, employee left on 16th. So he should get 1.25 as his eligibility at the time of termination. So how the system has to work and how we are going to adjust the PCR. First, if you have any questions on, you know, the requirement, you can post. So what I am creating is, the only thing we have to check over here is the separation action, what is there while writing the PCR. Before that, I will make the structure. This is PCR grouping. On the time tab. Then we have to check you know, a difference of the termination date. Before that, we'll take a termination action. There are two things. Let us say, if you remember, termination action is possibly there. Let us say we'll take termination action from 016. So employment status will go to withdrawn or yes. So our time evaluation will check the, you know, employment status. So if employment status is zero on a particular day, it won't run the time evaluation for them. It will run up to 15th itself. So for this, what we have to do is we have to create a time tag, the last working day. When you execute this action, you have to store a day type in InfoType 41. So now I am doing it manually, maintaining, you know, separation date. If you see here, in the actions, we have taken a separation action on 16th. So the same date, whatever you have a dynamic action, you can take the vector as his data while writing dynamic action. So in the 41 info type, I think we are already maintained something for, you know, technical data entry. So let us say when you write the dynamic action, just remember we will push it to data 12, so that it will be a bit dynamic action. So we will search for the data called last working day. Somewhere, I think, increment is there. We have two things actually, lost working day and the separation day. There is a day gap between lost working day and, let us say, here is lost working day. Okay, separation day is a separate one. There is a day gap over here, let us say, as we took 16/04/2000. Okay, so when you write a dynamic action, you have to write like this. You have to take DAT 12, that is day type, as well as day also you have to take test 12, that is the 12th field. So when you, it was saving, it will go to the next available field in the input type 41. So now we have maintained, whenever they take a separation action, it will be maintained in input type 41 with data called 42. So the same thing we are going to use. In the schema, L6 is there. I didn't check the actual Sagar, because I didn't remember what was the date for last one. So now what we have to do is we have to compare, because already the same operation we have used, if you remember. The data is I think. Here what we are checking is YSAA, means why I am using YSAA is there is the other option. At times if you go to the documentation to the Y, is the Y, right? This is equal to what I am using, Y. So we are getting time difference between two dates, right? So then you check the logic, Y followed by FGHJJ. So we have to catch up what FGH is there. So in F, what I am taking is Y, I am taking S as the next letter over there. So S stands for entry from date specifications input type 41. If it is not available, it will take the actions input type 000, that is the actual hiring date, right? Or if you are maintaining, if you are specifying any date type over there, here we specified 42 as the date, so it will take that date. If that date is not available, it will take the hiring date. Okay, let us say D also we can take. What D will do instead of S, if you are putting D, date specifications from input type 41, specify in variable 5. 5 is JJ, whatever the date you are mentioning. So what it will do is must maintain, see, the data must be maintained, otherwise time evaluation will terminate the process. So if you use D for the employees who don't have the termination date, the termination date is not mandatory, right? Only the separated employees will have the termination date. It will not run the time evaluation if the rule is on. Okay. So once our example is done, we'll use this D also. So then we will see what was happening. So that is why I am going to take S. So whenever the date AP is there, the date will be taken from here. If not, it will consider it as hiring date. Okay. Just think what was happening between D and S. That is the difference over here. So then followed by F is confirmed like Y S. Then I am taking again S, which is the duration, that is days. So for days, it is, you know, S, whatever YS, A I maintained. So date of time evaluation I maintained, but there it is 16, right? So our time evaluation will run up to 15th itself, because on 16th the employee was separated, inactive as per infotep. We have to use or we will modify this in the place of Z. Okay. Then H, what are the difference days should be calculated. So days only we are calculating, we are not calculating weeks or years or months or such kind of thing. So that is why I am using Y over here. Only this one I have to change it as R. So minus 1. So what we are doing, YS A, this should be R. So what it is telling is date of time evaluation. Today if it is, I think we have to use plus, right? So the PCR which we are reading, which we are writing over here. So I will show you first in the time evaluation, because we have already taken a termination action. So even if you run for 30th April, the time evaluation will run up to 15th itself. Right? So what it was, it will do at the time of, you know, generation of quota, there won't be relevant time tap. It won't generate any quota for us. It is blank, because on 15th itself the employee was terminated. So what we are going to catch up is, this is 15. In the data we maintain as 16. So the data minus 1, it will be 15. So we will see how the output will come. If the day is the same, so if the day is the same, we are going to generate the quota. If not, we are not going to generate the quota. So then what we have to do, let us say, for example, before going to more logic, what I am doing here is ADDDB Z901 says that I want to generate a verb for testing purpose. If it is any other day, I am telling leave over here. So we will see how this is working for us. Okay, it is 0 or not equal to 0, we will see. Or we can see if it is greater than or equal to 0 also. So these are the possibilities when you compare the things. Less than, greater than, and equal to. So we'll save this. We'll insert this PCR in our main schema first. So we need to insert. Already, I think you all know it should be, you know, above the quota function and CUMET function, because which will do the things. And we have to remember it should not be in any if or else function. And let us say if there is a prohibition period on, we have a calculation over here. If you remember the last sessions, if prohibition is true, means if we cross the prohibition, then only he is eligible for the remaining list. So you have to insert for here. Once the prohibition was gone and employee was terminated, then we have to insert with a ACTIO function with our PCR. Okay, if prohibition was not completed, even employee was terminated, he is not eligible for the quota. So that is why once the prohibition was completed, we are inserting here. So just think, here we are inserting, means we should understand the business, what really the HR users will do. Okay, they will check all these logics and they will do manually. Generally, if there is no SAP or no dependent software, if they are working with Excel. So the same thing we have to build the logic over here. So as of now, prohibition date I put as 0 so that he is eligible for this. So let us see what this was doing for us in the time evaluation. Right, so 15 is the so what we have, we got two PCRs. We will see what the first PCR is doing. We have a condition, I think last day of the payroll period, so first PCR won't run. Okay, so if you go to the second PCR which we have written, it is telling it is less than, so something wrong over here, right? So or which we are taking, we will go to the documentation again. Schema is not required. So you know we inserted the schema. Sagar, I just now saw your chart, but see here it is not the question of chart, the rounding part. So what will happen if you see here the date which we maintain in the time type, in the date type 42 is 16. Okay, so what it was taking, it is, if it is taking time evaluation day and it should match with the date which we are maintaining in the data 42 in InfoTab 41. So what here we are doing again, I am going to documentation. So I will go to white data tables. So what we have taken here is the Z, right? F, then I put R, then I put A, then I put the 42. So we'll go to variant Z, what we maintain Z, what it is telling date of time evaluation is 15, right? Actually, when the last date here we are working, this is the day 15. So what it should be in the date because this is the last working day, and the separation day is 16th. So we are maintaining as separation day as 16th over there. There is another thing where we can maintain 15 itself. Okay. So what we have to use is plus one we have to use. Okay. Instead of R we have to use S, so that the 15 will add with 1, that is 16. Then you will get the exact output over here.
Hello Krishna. Yeah, so the last working day is it 15 or 16? Like,
actually, as per the HRM, if you are talking, it is 15th itself, right?
Right.
But in the data, what we maintained is 16th.
So data 42 is like 16, right?
Yeah, 42 we maintained as 16th.
Okay.
See, generally why I am telling this, many people know about dynamic actions. I don't know in the 10 members, if somebody knows dynamic actions, it will be great. So you can come up. Somebody knows. Anyone is there who knows dynamic action? That's the basic dynamic action I am telling about. How you can trigger the things.
Yes, Krishna, we know. Yeah. We know how to generate dynamic action.
Yes. So how you will do is, whenever you are triggering a action, right?
Yeah.
You can pull that. Yes.
Yeah.
You can pull that start date.
Okay.
And you can push to a 41 info tab, right?
Yeah, absolutely right.
So what is the date? That is 16th only, because on 16th itself we are firing the employee, like separating the employee.
The system date it will take actually, side item. 16.
That's also you can take. Well, let us see.
Annually, you can date something.
No. See, if you go to real time, what they will do, they will take a separation action 5 days before or after the separation action.
Yeah, manually you can enter date.
Yes, manually you can enter. That is not the actual solution, but dynamically in the backend it should happen from the dynamic action. We can pull the date available in the info tab. Okay, so yeah. we have only the info tab date as vector, that is 16th.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is why I maintained as 16. Even if you don't know more about the dynamic actions also, many people will maintain 16 as the date, saying the separation date. Okay, and we have some other options in dynamic actions. Not some other options, we have many other options to work on that to, decrease the date to 15. If you decrease the date to 16, you can maintain, this function as A itself, the date. Because in the 41 info tab, we'll maintain the same date like 15. But here in our case, I am taking a small example. If you are maintaining, termination date, not the last working date, you can use S again or here. So it will subtract the date what you maintained. Here I maintained 16. So it will be subtracted the date. 16 minus 1, that will be 15. And it will check with the current time evaluation date. Then it will be easy to put over. So accordingly, see, if you are putting dynamic actions, if you can maintain 15, you can maintain this F, F, S, A, A. Right? If not, you can use F, S, S, A, A. A 42. Whatever. So here, if you observe, whatever the letters we are using over here up to here is for different purpose. So you have to check with the documentation. Again, accordingly, you have to change the code, especially these three things. Then a date example. Right? So I am explaining more about the tools, how can we use, right? That depends, because this is not the only requirement for your client. You will have n number of requirements, so that basing on that you can work on this. So let us see how this will work. See here, it went to equal to, because I added a gate to you know that 15. I subtracted a I added that for the current time evaluation. I added a date from 15 to 16, and I am checking with the date which is stored in 42. So it went to is equal to. So if it is the termination date, we are going to generate the quota for the particular employee. So if you see, it will be, because you all know, you know, we are generating one means you will get one, right? So then what we have to do to get the actual quota in the PCR, I think everybody knows, instead of giving one, what we have to do, the same logic what we have written in the PCR. What is the PCR we have written for this?
It is at 910. It is 910.
This is the so what we are doing, we are checking all this stuff. Instead of checking all these things, we can copy the same thing there. I think it won't happen over here. If I do, we have to write it manually. Let us see if it will happen or not. So the same logic, it should work, right? At the time of termination also, because the days and everything will be the same. It won't happen. The same logic we have to, you know, make it here. That I am doing just copy and paste. If somebody have a simple solution, let me know how to do this. As of now, I didn't get the solution how to do. You people got what I am doing, right? So whatever the logic we have written on the termination date, we are doing the same logic. I didn't done any changes. If it is termination day, then I am calling whatever the days he worked, then and dividing with the current day. This will be a bit deferred, maybe. Right? I think we have to capture something about this. This will be 15th of the period. So if you work for 15 and if it is dividing with 15, he is eligible for, you know what. So he will get the complete quota instead of getting all this stuff. This we have to take care. If we run, I think it will credit 2.5 on the termination. It is getting 2.5 better because we are using current date. So we have to, you know, catch up. The last time also we have written a rule like to catch up the end date of the month. So here we didn't have any you know, standard thing to catch up the end date of the month, but we have to build a logic like you know.
Krishna,
yes.
Can we need to capture the present days, like the number of days that the employee has worked, and then use the Z910, pass that the current date is like 15, last working day is 15, we should capture 15 and pass that 15 into Z910.
We have to do one thing, see. There is a difference, right? What I am telling is actually why. See, what we have done is per month, but apart from leap year, we maintain some constant. See, let us say employee works for 15 days, right? He is eligible for 30 or 2.5, right? For one per month, right? The actual days are 30. If you say you have to do this, right? Means you have to catch how many how much is eligible, then only you will get the actual 0.5 1.25 which is eligible. So basing on the month,
So for that, I think we are capturing the number of days from Z911, I guess.
Yeah, we are capturing all this stuff. That's what we are. See, what I am telling you. We have, you know, the 15 over here. But B, C, R, D, Y, it will capture the current day. It's not capturing the present day. See, let us say if you are telling... if client is telling it should be like a fixed number called 30 days, right? If I am hard coding that, if I run, he will get the exact output because in the month of April he has 30 days and he worked up to 15 days. So if you see the output, the quota will be, you know, 1.25, which is correct. But let the same thing has happened. Okay, in the month of February, it can be 28 or 29 again. So then there will be a difference, right? So what I have to do is generally what we done in the previous thing is we maintain some constants for February especially, and we maintained a PCR. If you have a function, if you remember, in our session, like where we can check, let us say if I'm writing a, we can check the current month, CURMO, right? If you remember the carry forward things, we are checking CURMO. That is checking the current period. If it is the current period 1, we can take a variable called with the variable like 30 days, with the variable like 31 days, you know, we had 12 things, 12 months, we can take it, and the number we can, if it is a leap year, then we can, whatever the constant we are taking, we will take the number from the constant. So for the leap years, you can maintain, you know, the constant like this. That's what it was happening. 15 by 15, it was creating.
But Krishna, there is no way to capture the number of days in a month. No standard operation is available.
As of now, I think it's not available.
Okay.
Number of days in the month. Right. What we will generally do is we will capture the end day whenever we are writing a rule, or we can maintain a constant for February especially. Whenever you are calculating, you can create a constant like Feb, and you can create say 28 up to here. You can go for delimit this. Let us say from whenever the leap year is there, the constant you can change. Let us say the leap year forms from 01/01/2000 or the year. 18. So from 18 you can give it as 29. Right. So again you can delimit from the next year whatever you are maintaining. You can maintain it at 28. So if you are calling this constant as the number of days in your PCR, there won't be any issues for almost 20 years. This is the thing I have done in a client called Suscan Technologies in Bangalore. So we can write that logic, but when the termination was happened, you can build, or else you can develop a operation to calculate the month days. Even I will check again how to capture month days. As of now, there is no standard operation to catch up the month days. If you have anything, you can go to the HRS this thing, how you can catch up the month and days. And this is the thing we are using, BCUR, that will give the current day from the system tables. instead of you can capture the period of the month. If it is April, you can catch at 30th. If it is May, you can catch as 31, like that. So here, as of now, I hard coded this thing. So maybe in the next session, I will, you know, next class, I will tell how to decode. So any questions on this as of now?
So as of now, we are just hard coding, right? 30.
Yes, as of now we are hard coding. Actually, what we have to do is we have to write a PCR to catch up the days in the month.
Okay.
You got it?
Yeah.
You write a PCR above that, just push it to a enter.
Is there any other shortcut method, like, because this is getting complicated? Like,
not really complicated, but you can, you know, write a simple PCR to catch up. If this is the month April, what we have done is, if it is month April, we are pushing the 10th as 30 on the particular day to the day balance table. Here we are calling that table. Okay.
Okay.
Anyhow, I will check the shortcut. What is the best possible thing, and I will let you.
Okay. Okay.
Anything else for the day?
Krishna, sorry for asking this. I lost somewhere. So this scenario is relating to that in the middle of the termination, you have written that PCR. Or what is
yes.
it scenario?
That's what if employee is separated in the middle of the month.
Okay, thank you.
Because by the end of the month only we are going to pay it. If employee is separated at the end of the month, what we are going to do? Anything else? Thiru?
Thank you.
Yeah. Shweta, no questions? Have you worked more on anything?
No, I didn't work on another thing.
Okay.
But this is quite complicated, right? We are querying each month. If we are using CURMO, then we have to query January, February, till December.
Yes, we have. I will show you few of the PCRs what I have written in the client. But we should have some other technology. We have some other options to do that.
Okay.
You know, which we have to take web help. Okay. Without that, what is the best scenario? I will let you know.
Okay. Krishna, I was working on one more scenario. I had used this accrual quota. I had used the in base entitlement. I had used the field or seniority. So,
okay.
I had stated that 0 to 1 year, the seniority. So, up to 1 year it has to generate. So, the problem what I was facing was this employee was hired on, for example, 15th of March. So, 28th February it is generating 2.5, but March end it is not generating anything.
Can you tell me one thing? You are using positive time management or time evaluation?
PM04.
So you check the seniority within the PCR itself. Don't use the tables. See, you have to follow the same thing. If you are using PCR, you use complete PCR. Don't use tables.
Means what you are saying is I have to check InfoTech 41. Or is there any other option?
You have option, you check with the wife. From his date of birth, you will get. From his hiring date, you will get. Right?
Okay.
You didn't get my point. I will show you just there. See, You are telling you should get seniority is the one thing.
See, for example,
we are already working on Y, right?
Yes.
Right. What Y is telling, if you use A, you will get date of birth.
Okay.
Okay. You will get the age if you are telling about the age senior.
No, I'm not telling about
You are telling about his
service anniversary,
you have S again. What you are getting, it is getting from, you just give YS, YS if you have given, it will take the date from, actions. If you put NN as blank, this ZJ as blank, it will take the date from his actual hiring date. Then go down, if you want years, how much years he was experienced, you can give these things. So you can use any of the things. For the current time evaluation period, you can use A. The comparison, how many years if you want. You can use Y or here in the logistic.
Yeah, I tried with this, Krishna. Whatever you're saying, the same thing I tried. But the problem what is happening is... Yeah, same thing. HRS is equal to YSEA, Y and the date type I'm giving. It is...
Why you are giving? What is
okay, no need
so
to
it
get
will,
it.
It will take from... This is what you have to give.
Okay, this side in
fact. Sorry, this is not correct. YS, AY, I hope. We'll check again. See, in this, Y, anyhow, you should give. So, here is the Y you are giving. Then you have to give S, then followed by YS. Then you have to give A. YSAY, you have to give. This will work for you.
So if I want to stop this accrual...
What you have to do is, you have to tell HRS, compare with, if you are telling some employee, if he has 10 years experience, then you have to tell like this, if he is greater than or less than, then you have to continue with this route, if it is 10 years.
But we are generating it only on the last day of the month, right? So if it is completing 1 year by 15th of March, so for 15 days it is not calculating 1.25, that was my question.
Then you have to build your own logic again, right?
Okay, similarly, like what you are showing today.
Yes, right. Then you have to build up your logic. If there is a bank change, what you are doing? If we work right from M to N, if you change, we done something. So if it is a seniority change, you have to do the same thing.
Okay, I will try, Krishna. Thank you.
So any questions from anybody? And a small information again that maybe tomorrow I won't be available. Tomorrow and day after tomorrow, it's not confirmed still, but maybe our classes may interrupt tomorrow and day after tomorrow. If it was confirmed, Chaitanya will inform you. If not, we will continue from tomorrow.
Krishna, and one more thing, yes, if sir. You have time, I have a general question, not relating to today's class or anything. If you have time, you can tell that. See, now, from the past, like nowadays, most of the openings are coming in eastern side and west side. Most of the guys are asking SAP success factor. So, how it will be?
Today you are a bit late to the session, I hope.
Yeah.
We already had the same discussion. So, the same thing. So, way of success factors is good for HR, not for payroll. In my view, it's my view, okay? Whatever you ask, you pose to me.
Okay.
Success factor is a failure for payroll and time management. It is good for, PMS, LSO, training and event management. Whatever the sub-modules, actual HR people will do.
Okay.
That is the thing. So, for remaining, I don't think for another 100 years, SAP will be there.
Sorry, what is it?
For another 100 years, SAP R3 will be there for payroll. It's a must develop. While you are coming to payroll, if you are an accounting consultant or if you are a CI, you can understand what really SAP has developed for all the countries, almost covering the major countries in the world. A small cloud computing thing will come and it will orbit within a span of 10, 15, 20 years. It is almost not possible. It is my view. I am not kidding because I am a payroll consultant or a time consultant. Even I am a PMS consultant and I know all the remaining modules. But don't afraid. This was, we know all these talks from when I was into the SAP, then we have a talk like by 2010 there won't be SAP in the market. So still we are fighting, there is SAP again, we got SAP success factor. So don't worry, we will improve with the technology again, but we should focus about the subject and the business process what it was going. So that is why here whenever I explain you a topic, I am telling this is the business requirement, that is the reason we are doing this. So if you know that, really will be there, whatever the technology is here. Right?
Krishna, I just have one last question.
Yes,
every time we are querying InfoTech 41, is there any option to query employment status or action InfoType directly and check if the employment status is active or inactive or withdrawn? Instead of checking InfoType 41,
we have all those things.
Okay.
Right, but the only thing why we are going for this thing is, let us say that's a good question. Actually, when I was new to time evaluation, I used to check the same action type. If so and so action type is there, then do something else, right? That's what your question, right? We have that actually.
Yes, actually,
what will happen is, just listen to me, sir. I'm coming to your point, okay?
So,
we can check if action type 10 is there, do something else. But unfortunately, our time evaluation will run up to this date itself. So on the particular day, the action type will be 01 only. It's not 010. 10.
Okay.
That is the reason we are working with.
The reason why I asked this question was, we have got various action types like suspension, absconding, where we are making the employment status as inactive and nothing is accrued during those inactive period, and again when the employee comes back we are reinstating and making him active. So that's why, can we query employment status and write this PCRs?
How you will get employment? That's what I am telling. See, time evaluation and the dynamic actions are very closely related. While I learning the time evaluation, I thought dynamic actions is no way used, but it is the thing which we have to do. We have to learn dynamic actions vastly. Without knowledge of the user, the dynamic actions will fail.
Okay, so only option is to query input a 41, right, and get the date and compare and then do the calculation.
See, if you are telling only option, there are many options. SAP standard methodology is 41. If you are not familiar with dynamic actions or something,
okay,
you can go for user exits for PA30.
Mm-hmm.
It will trigger the things back end, it will save the relevant data apps and these things. And if you are not really interested in maintaining 41 at all,
okay,
you can create your own operations.
That is for other coding, right?
Your own functions and all this stuff.
Okay.
Okay. Right?
Okay.
That is a separate point. That also I will show you how to do. But it's not SAP standard functionality. In future, SAP won't support you on these cases.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And Krishna, just one more thing. We have a lot of rehire cases. So, for example, in current today's class, you explained that we are terminating him and maintaining the date in info type 41.
Mm-hmm.
And again, in the same info type, after 2 years, we are rehiring him and we are maintaining the same date type. So, obviously, SAP is based on start date and end date. So, whenever we are querying this in our PCR, will the system check the record with 31129999? I mean, the latest record and read?
You are again a bit confused, maybe. What is the PCR we have written? This one, right?
Yeah.
See, if you remember, if it is less than or greater than, I am not taking anything. If it is equal to only, I am working on it.
No, Krishna, my question is, can you please go to info type 41? Okay, I'll just tell you. See, now we are terminating him on 16th of April 2015 and you save this record. And
okay,
we are hiring him on, again rehiring him on 1st Jan 2016.
Okay,
so 01 will be again maintained. You cannot maintain with the same start date.
No. Why you will maintain 01? It's a technical entry date of the particular employee code. If you are doing a rehire, you have to maintain a data called rehire.
Okay.
Why you maintain a technical date rehire?
Okay, we are rehiring. You maintain a separate data type for rehiring. And again, we are terminating him in next year, say December.
Oh,
so
right.
42, can we maintain 42 again? Because we have lot of rehire cases termination because...
See, n number of times you can maintain 42. See, that is that thing I am telling, na, rehiring, whatever the you have to maintain, rehire over here, okay, and 42 you can maintain the same thing, and you have a logic whenever you are, running the time evaluation, okay, it won't go to the initial date, what is 1st of April, because in between there is a... inactive status, whenever the employee is active, then only it will go. Okay, and if you are coming to rehire couple of times, let us say. Okay, rehired, terminated, then rehired. So you have to put a logic like which is the latest one.
Okay, Can you, it will not allow, Krishna. Can you just maintain 42 and maintain some date and try to save? It won't allow. I tried that.
Same date won't allow because there is a date error. It will all right.
No, no, different date. Maintain, mention it as 2016.
No, no, same date app, it won't allow.
Yeah, it will not allow. What we have to do is, the start and end date of this record.
No, no, no. What I am telling, na? See, whenever you are having a rehire, you can copy this info tab and you can create on the from the particular date. And when you are using from the reporting, you can pull the latest record.
So that logic, do we have to specifically write in PCR or automatically the system will consider the latest record? See, whichever is 31129999.
What I am telling you, you still didn't understand the logic of PCR. So what it is doing, it is itself checking the date. On 1st of April, if you are checking InfoType 41, it will check the start date and end date, whatever the details are there, it will put. Right? If it is on end of on 50th of April, it will catch the date it is falling under the particular dates or not. Have you worked what you are asking me?
Yes, yes, I tried. It was, first of all, it was not allowing me to maintain a data same date type. Then what I did, I delimited this record. I created a new record with 31129999.
You try this. Okay, okay, our time evaluation will check the date, then only it will, you know, it will read. Let us say if you want some example for year itself, I'm going to change. I'm giving as 2018.
Okay.
Right? What are the data types are there? What are the things are there? Not doing anything because there is no data for the particular time period, right?
Okay.
So it will check the validity period.
Yeah. Okay.
So whenever you have, so anything else from anybody? The only thing,
Krishna, one last question.
Yes, yes, Agar.
Yeah, so based on the last lecture, we had a table called based on the time type and process type.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, can you just open that table for a bit?
No, Sagar, actually for all time, we are going to start from that table itself.
Okay, okay. Yeah, actually I was working. Okay, okay.
Yes,
I'll ask when you start the order.
I will show you again, no issues, because it really means for everybody.
Yeah, I was working on a scenario that that is why I had a question. It is T555 something.
5Y and Z. Both
yeah.
Are similar.
Yeah, yes, yes.
No, it's not executed. Yes.
So for our thing, it is 0102 and 99. 0102 99. The second last column.
Okay.
Yeah, so now we are, because we are, it is attendance, then it is, we are, time type is Z com, and the P type 3, it is S. What is S over here? Like, it, when I check the documentation, it is the planned working time.
Yes.
So, but I did not get the significance of this S.
No, no, it's not like, you know, S is actual working time. Let us say we have few process types, like, you know, M stands for work time, S stands for, you know, plan time, like P stands for, let us say if you have used P for example to generate attendance yesterday. Okay, likewise you can use this, it is used. Right?
Yeah.
So whenever you maintain a process type over here, it will store in front of your time type. Okay. Basing on this, let us say what I will do in future, means in the coming classes, is I will maintain like M.
Okay.
Okay. So then if it is M, whatever the hours are there in the particular time type, I will pull it as what M hours.
Okay.
Okay. Then so you will be able to understand what S stands for, what M stands for, what Z stands for.
Okay. Okay.
Right? It's a process type which will be stored in our what I can say in the any of the pair types. See, if you can see, yes, M over here, it is related to this. When you are coming to this particular topic, you can understand what is S here, and if you change to M, what will be the M, like this.
Okay.
If it is, so we have a process types table again. Python S and all this stuff. It's a, you know, again the next class you can understand.
Okay.
We are on the way. We are on the way.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Makes sense.
Yeah.
And one more thing is, like in general, somebody asked about the success factors. So there is an ERP called as Workday, which is, you know, very getting popular in the market right now. So how? So how is it like, because I'm getting calls for, you know, working into Workday also.
That depends actually, even I'm not a market analyst.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
That depends on the individual decision.
Right, but have you heard about, but, I mean.
Yes, like, yes, even Workdays I heard. Okay, see, I'm not telling that the success factors is not good or Workday is not good or SAP is not good. But the only thing I suggest is whatever you learn completely. And we should be professionals on that. Once you are a professional on in any of the, you know, software, you will be working good on other software also.
Yeah, Siddharth is saying that Workday is popular in US. Yeah, because you are in US, there are so many openings in Workday. More than SAP, I can see Workday openings over here. So they are asking, like, I mean, if you have SAP experience, we will be training you in Workday and then you can start working on it. So at this point, I was confused because I have this SAP experience also, and people are asking me to go into Workday also. So I was a bit confused. So just.
It depends. So whatever we learn.
No, actually in India, no, there are only few companies who are following this Workday, and there are very limited consultants. They are also not using it at all because they are going to SAP all again.
Yeah, but Siddharth, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, Siddharth, right now I'm in US, so I'm looking for a job in US. So over here, I think on Workday. So just I had a question to ask. That's it.
Okay.
I have about few of the friends who are working in Accenture with Workday. So they are also not, means as a consultant, they are not satisfied with their job.
Okay. Accenture, I am not sure. Yeah, yeah.
Maybe they skipped from their technology or something. I hope they are working previously or some other software, not with SAP actually, but still I am not sure. That is a, you know, open question for everybody.
Right, right, right. Anyways, I'll see. Thank you.
Yeah. Till then, see you guys. It's already 10:10 for me, so we'll meet you tomorrow positively. If something is, you know, if we are not having class, I think you have to be patient for a couple of days. So I will inform if we are having class tomorrow or not.
Okay.
Thank you, Rami. Hello.
Thank you. Thank you, Krishna.